Welcome back to the Delaware Way. It makes sense. Ben DuPont is renovating and has purchased the DuPont Country Club in New Castle County. So I understand you're putting a lot of money into this.
We are.
How much?
We're putting a $19 million first crack renovation. We will.
That's only the start.
We will invest more.
Let's back up for a second. When you say we, who are you talking
about? So I have a partner, Don Worth, and the two of us bought it together.
And what do you hope to do with this?
So first, we're not developing it in any way. That's one of the motivations, certainly. Certainly a condition of DuPont's sale that it not be developed. But it's also in our DNA. So we're not adding any commercial, any homes or anything like that. We hope to invest and reinvigorate it. It's a beautiful facility, 525 acres, three 18-hole golf courses, 26 tennis courts, but hardly any fitness and no pools. And so we're adding three to four pools. You're going to see some excitement on that soon. Some announcements coming out. We're adding 15,000 square foot of state-of-the-art fitness. We have renovated the restaurant and the bar area. That's already complete. And we're adding a world-class indoor golf training facility, 10,000 square feet. Be able to play golf year-round. Sit inside, hit a golf ball outside. And all the electronics is pretty sophisticated in that. Get bored of that. You can lower the screen, play on a screen. Behind you is a full service restaurant and bar. And so a lot of exciting things going out. And we hope to, after this $19 million, continue to invest at about $1 million clip per year on additional capital improvement.
And so you're obviously looking for new members too.
Well, we have 420 new members so far, which is we're way ahead of where we thought we would be. In its heyday, the club had 9,000 members. We bought it had about 1,700, so we're back to 2,100. Our magic bogey is 3,000 members. We're happy.
I like the word magic bogey. Where does that come from? I like the idea of the history of the place. I mean, in a way, you're keeping this in the DuPont family. I know it was a company-owned place,
right. Well, I mean, we're trying to create something a little new. We want this to be. In an ideal world, a benevolent organization would have bought it and done what we're doing. Sometimes we look around and organization doesn't exist. Maybe we're the benevolent organization.
But the DuPont company had it for its employees.
It's almost 100 years old today.
Boy, that's a time going by.
I know.
Did it break your heart with the merger with DuPont?
No. I mean, it's certainly bittersweet. But look, companies have to do things to modernize and improve and stay current. And this looks like would have been a natural evolution. And I think the concept of combining Dow and DuPont and taking the as it's been described to me that the combined entity Corteva is the biggest ag company in the space and the new DuPont will be the biggest in specialty chemicals, and the new Dow will be the biggest in its fields as well. So in a time where scale matters, I think that it's an important thing.
I was talking to somebody who was talking about these mergers on the show, and they said, it does look bad at first when these mergers happen. Right. But what happens is you displace some brilliant people.
Right.
And new companies spring up from that.
Exactly.
And you also have this talent pool that other states don't have because DuPont attracted them all here. Is that happening?
I think it's absolutely happening. And you look back in history, it's happened. I mean, it happens to great companies all across our country. Gore was kind of a spin out of DuPont in some regards. And so I think this will happen. I mean, look, the neat thing about the world we live in today, I think, is everybody's an entrepreneur, right? And I think that's a good thing. I think it makes it more talent-based, less tenure-based. And so I think with all these bright scientists and engineers, some of whom DuPont and Corteva are keeping, I think many, but other exciting things will be happening. And I'm an optimist in the American entrepreneurial spirit, and I'm an optimist about Delaware for that same reason.
Is there ever part of you, because you talk about government and you talk about your father,
obviously,
you're very proud of.
Yep.
Ever a part of you that says, I want to get involved in politics? I want to change it from the inside?
No, not really. I have a pretty good life right now. I'm able to contribute where I think I can make some contributions. But here's the funny thing about the world is sometimes, because of the way the world works, social media and things, people on the outside can change things more on the inside. You know, the guys who started Amazon, Jeff Bezos, was not a bookseller. The guys who started Uber weren't experts in logistics and transportation. The guys who started Airbnb, by the way, Marriott, who their biggest competitor is, they'll tell you Airbnb. The founders of Airbnb were not hotel, you know, people from the outside can innovate. And so I hope to play. I have a strong interest in making sure this is an exciting, dynamic, successful state. So my kids and grandkids and your kids and grandkids can grow up and have exciting and fun things to do. And their best option isn't to move to some other city.
So you want to change state government from the outside?
I think I can help change state government from the outside. Yes, I do.
I love watching you speak. It's even better meeting you.
Thank you very much.
Ben DuPont, partner at Chartline. When we come back, some new ideas for preserving Delaware's outdoors when the Delaware Way continues.